Go.
Okay, the first word we're going to discuss in the Bible is the word lasciviousness. Lasciviousness is a King James word. Like NIV version and other versions will not use this word. They might use the word lust or immorality, or lasciviousness is a great word found in Corinthians, Peter, and in Jude, okay? Now basically, lascivious means stirring up or having no borders, no guidelines. For example, if you're single, not even married, just a single man or single lady, you can actually be a lascivious person because you have no guidelines in your life. In other words, you're entering into relationships with girls or boys, but you have no pre-established borders, no pre-established guidelines in your life. You know, you might be saying to yourself, well, if I really love them and if I'm, you know, maybe if we're going out together for 6 months or three, then maybe I might kiss them if I think they're really, you know, good, you know, or something. You're already lascivious if you're thinking that way, okay? A lascivious person will ahead of time establish the do's and don'ts in their life based on biblical standards, what is reasonable and what is right. Paul says in the book of Corinthians, all things are lawful, but not all things are profitable. In other words, you can do things in life, but not all things you do in life are a good idea. So lascivious is basically stirring up yourself or stirring up others. It might be in the way that you talk or walk or dress. You know, sometimes men are really guilty of this. They're telling the girl, I love you, or you're really sweet, or I really like you, or I'm thinking about you all the time. Text messaging is really big, in the Philippines especially, and even in the West. But telling somebody these words might be stirring them up. So the way we talk to each other is very important. But everybody today, oh, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. And they have no idea what they're really saying. You know, many people even think love is a feeling. But love is not a feeling. Love is a choice. Love comes from your will. Love is a willing of the highest good of the other person. And so when we're so careless in the way that we talk to each other, by phone or by letters or email, we might be stirring them up to have emotions that God did not want them to have. Is that clear? So we have to be self-controlled. In the book of Galatians, it says one of the fruit of the Spirit, along with the other fruit, the very last fruit on the list, is actually self-control. So someone that is really a spiritual man or a spiritual woman should have self-control. And self-control is exercised in the way that you talk to each other, the way that you walk. You know, like some of these girls, they put on their short skirts and they walk like this. They're going to stir people up just going down the street. It's lasciviousness. And men can be the same way. You know, these men that, you know, they just, they dress and they act in a way that creates an atmosphere of, you know, getting girls stirred up, you know. Maybe they like walking around with no shirt on, you know, with their just not because of the sun or anything, but because they want to show off their body. Yeah, they put their sunglasses on, and yeah, I'm cool, man. Look at my body. Lasciviousness. So talking, walking, dressing, having no limits, no borders, no guidelines. Is a river good or bad? Tell me, is a river good or bad?
Good.
Can a river be bad? A river can be good and bad. A river with banks, a river with a good border or a bank, yeah, can provide energy, power to a city, fish can flow, yeah, boats can go on there, transportation, a good river, energy, power, electricity, commerce, export, import, right? But a river with no banks, what's going to happen? It's going to be a flood, right? A river with no banks is a flood. Is a flood good or bad?
Bad.
It's bad. A flood is water going all directions without limits. Destroys homes, kills people, destroys cars, destroys farmland. Who says a flood is a good thing? Well, a person, a moral being, without guidelines, standards, limits, is like a flood. Too much, excess, letting yourself go. Oh, come on, let's just let yourself go.
But no, come on.
Last night I received an email on my YouTube video about last December. We were preaching at a homosexual parade here in Manila. And so I had an email that said, oh, come on, get with the times. You're old-fashioned, they said. You know, this is the homosexuality is acceptable today. We need to be more tolerant of them. It's, you know, everybody's doing it, basically. Let yourself go. That's basically what they were telling me. I'm sorry, we don't follow the signs of the times. Christians are fish that swim upstream, not downstream. Yeah. Well, Christians go upstream. We don't go with the crowd. We're not on the wide road. We're on the narrow road. And Jesus said, enter the narrow road. It's a straight life. It's a narrow life. He said there's just a few people on it leading to eternal life. But the road to destruction is a wide road. Everybody's on it, letting themselves go. Unbelievable. Oh, just let it all hang out. That's a famous phrase in the West. Let it all hang out. Just let your love flow. You ever hear that song? I'm sorry, love does not flow. Love is a choice. Love comes from your will. It's not a it's not a liquid. It's not a gas. It's not something you can put in a test tube you can't pour out love. Love is not an object. Love is not a material thing. Love is a choice. It comes from your will. Love is not a feeling. But 99% of every song on secular radio describes love as a feeling. Feelings. Nothing more than feelings. I'm sorry, Christians don't live by feelings. We live by the Word of God, by truth, by principles, by guidelines. We are not to be lascivious. Lascivious. It's sin. And the wages of sin is death.